Good evening. The state television company Western Armenia represents the most important events of these days. Today's broadcast. News from Western Armenia. Aznavour Foundation receives 105 tons of humanitarian aid for war-affected population of Artsakh. Human Rights Watch. Armenian prisoners of war abused in Azerbaijani custody. Artsakh Ministry of Foreign Affairs. Aliyev's visits are the embodiment of the Armenian-hating militaristic policy of Baku. Photo of Armenian St. Hovhannes Church in Iran as the winner of Wikilove's Monuments Contest. Armenia presents its tourism potential at leading Russian tourism exhibition. Today is Vartuhi Vartelesyan's birthday. The Agar-Kars highway is closed to vehicles as a result of unfavorable weather conditions in the Agar province, Western Armenia. Road snow removing crews continue their work. A group of bears caused an atmosphere of fear on the road to Children Van. The group of bears appeared in the evening near Ashag Mutlu district of Children province in order to find food. A passerby managed to catch four bears on the phone, which left the area after a while. The Malatya Gastronomic Tourism and Advertising Association, which was created to promote the city's tourism and food culture, will hold the Apricot Flowers Festival on March 19 to 21. Today, the Aznavour Foundation received about 105 tons of humanitarian aid for the population affected by the second war in Artsakh. The press service of the foundation reports, with the support of the Crisis and Support Center of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs of the French Republic, this new batch of aid was sent to Armenia by sea freights, then transported to Yerevan by land. The customs clearance of humanitarian cargo was carried out by the Aznavour Foundation in accordance with the applicable legislation. This batch of humanitarian aid includes medical supplies, in particular functional medical beds, as well as clothing and hygiene items. This unprecedented mobilization was possible thanks to the hard work of more than 50 organizations and 100 donors, solidarity and perseverance. In total, over 175 tons of humanitarian aid was collected at 19 reception points in France and Switzerland through the Aznavour Foundation and its partner organizations. Azerbaijani forces abused Armenian prisoners of war from the 2020 Nagorno-Karabakh conflict, subjecting them to cruel and degrading treatment and torture either when they were captured during their transfer or while in custody at various detention facilities. As reported by Armen Press, the statement of Human Rights Watch said, "The abuse, including torture of detained Armenian soldiers, is abhorrent and a war crime," said Hugh Williamson, Europe and Central Asia director at Human Rights Watch. He stressed that such war crimes should immediately be held accountable. Human Rights Watch interviewed four former prisoners of war who detailed their ill treatment in custody, as well as the ill treatment of other prisoners of war with whom they were captured or shared cells. Demonstrating flagrant disrespect for the ongoing efforts to find a long-term solution to the conflict between Azerbaijan and Artsakh, President of Azerbaijan Ilham Aliyev visited the occupied Hadrut region of Artsakh. Artsakh Ministry of Foreign Affairs noted, "While in the occupied territories, President Aliyev, among other things, personally instructed the officials accompanying him to erase medieval Armenian inscriptions from the walls of churches and monuments in the occupied territories. Such official visits are yet another embodiment of Azerbaijan's hateful and militaristic policy and its further aggressive plans," the statement noted. Artsakh has already informed the international community about the cultural terrorism carried out by Azerbaijan at the state level. Its actions to destroy the Armenian cultural heritage in the territories under its military occupation and the gross promotion of a genocidal expansionist policy. This genocidal policy is a crime against humanity, a gross violation of international norms, conventions, resolutions, agreements, and poses a threat to the entire civilized world. We call on the relevant international organizations to take all necessary measures to prevent the destruction of the Armenian cultural heritage, condemnation of the genocidal policy of Azerbaijan. Inaction and indifference are fraught with unpredictable consequences. Farzin Izadov's Dars photo of the Armenian St. Hovhannes Church in Iran won the Wikilove's Monuments Photography Contest. "This image is stunning," a jury member said of this snapshot of Iran's St. Hovhannes Church that won first place in this year's competition. Wikimedia informs, "Farzin Izadov's Dars captured this timeless moment one day after a snowstorm came through and submitted it to Wikilove's Monuments because they thought everyone needed to see it. The Church of St. Hovhannes is a 5th or 6th century Armenian Catholic church in Sohrol, Shabestar County, Iran. It was rebuilt in 1840 by Samson Makintsev in brick on the older church foundation." Armenia has presented its tourism potential at the Moscow International Travel and Tourism Trade Show, which took place in the Russian capital from March 16 to 18, the Ministry of Economy reported via Armen Press. 20 tour companies from Armenia participated in the exhibition with the support of the Tourism Committee of the Ministry of Economy, the leading international travel and tourism trade show in Russia and the Commonwealth of Independent States, has been attended by 1,500 companies from 229 countries. Earlier, the Tourism Committee, in cooperation with 21 tourism companies, participated in one of the largest online international exhibitions, ITB Berlin, from March 9 to 12. Bartui Vartaresyan was born on March 19, 1928, in Bucharest, Romania. She is the wife of actor, playwright Gheorghe Abagian. She moved to Armenia in 1946. The first spectacle took place in the Nubarashen Self-Made Theater. In 1947, she entered the studio attached to the Leningrad Drama Theater and played on the theater stage. In 1958, she moved to the Sundukyan Theater of Yerevan. She has performed many roles in the theater, including Margarit in Shirvanzade's Batvi Hamar, Ranevskaya in Chekhov's The Cherry Orchard, Claire Sakhnasyan in Duremes' The Visit of the Old Lady, Joni in Sarian's My Heart is in the Mountains, Princess and others. She also played roles of Western Armenians, Bakhtasar Akhbar, Anush and others. She acted in Batvi Hamar, Mor Sirte, Road to the Stage, Hayrik, Karine and other films. The Golden Fund of the National Radio of Armenia has more than 100 recordings of her. She has been acting in television shows since 1958. She was one of the first TV actresses. In 1985, she was invited to the Adamyan Theater in Aleppo, Syria, where she was awarded a Golden Medal. She has received numerous higher state diplomas, awards, letters of gratitude. In 1965, she was awarded the title of People's Actor of the Armenian SSR. In 1988, the title of People's Actor of the USSR. In 1995, she was awarded the R.A. Movses Khorenatsi Order. In 2001, the title of Honorary Citizen of Yerevan. In 2013, the Order of St. Mesrop Mashtots. She is buried in the Komitas Pantheon. Now I present you Eskişehir Aşnan Gişer by Zartong Ensemble. The full version is available on the official website of Western Armenia TV. This was all for today. Goodbye.